the news. Coverage you can count on.
Breaking now, an optimistic update from the Allegheny County Health Department. Thanks for joining us. I'm Gordon Lesh. Health officials are reporting 311 new cases since Saturday. So that's a two-day report, and it's less than what we've been seeing lately for just one day. The county has also learned of one additional death. And we've also learned that President Joe Biden is expected to announce new mask guidance tomorrow. Sources say he will release an update on wearing masks outdoors. You'll see Johnson & Johnson shots being offered again today. The CDC and FDA took a closer look at several cases of severe blood clots and have green-lighted the vaccine again. The vaccine on Friday, the CDC's advisory committee determined the incidents were extremely rare and that the Johnson & Johnson vaccine is safe and effective.
This was the necessary steps they needed to take to keep the public safe, to figure out what kind of a risk we were dealing with, and then get the best information to people.
More than 9 million doses of the J&J vaccine are ready to be given out in the U.S. About 8% of Americans have missed their second dose of the two-dose vaccines. The CDC says that number is up from 3.4% back in March. It could be vaccine hesitancy, but the CDC says the numbers don't take into account people who get their first dose at one clinic and then get their second shot at a different clinic. Americans who have been fully vaccinated will be allowed to fly to Europe again this summer, but officials have not set a date when Americans will be allowed back, and there are no details on exactly how this would work, including how tourists would prove they've been vaccinated. If you got a vaccine, you have a vaccine card to prove it, and Channel 11's Mike Holden explains why you need to hang on to it.
By now, many of us have already received the COVID-19 vaccine, but what are we supposed to do with that coveted card? Experts are saying it's super simple, and it starts with taking a photo of it so you have it on record.
The COVID-19 vaccine card is viewed as a prized possession by many at this point. Whether you get it at a large-scale clinic like this or a smaller appointment, it contains important details. The card highlights the number of doses you received and the provider who administered the shot along with the date. Officials say taking a picture of the card is essential. That way, if it gets lost or damaged, you still have a backup digital copy. Regardless, they recommend sliding the physical card into a safe space. At this point, it's not clear when and where you may need to show the card for proof of vaccination. However, officials stress it contains verified details and acts as a paper trail. The card will likely be needed to document your booster shot in the near future. If you misplace it, they say, assistance is available.
We recommend contacting your provider that you received your doses. They can issue you a new card. Not to panic, because it is kept on record in their electronic health record where you've received your dose. It is also stored in our, what's called our, the PA, the Department of Health, as a PA immunization information system, where all of our doses that you receive for immunizations are also recorded there.
And if you plan on sharing your COVID-19 vaccination card on social media with a selfie, make sure you block out all of the personal details. More on that side of the story for Channel 11 News starting at 5, plus what you should do if your card has been laminated. That's all starting at 5. Reporting this afternoon, Mike Holden, Channel 11 News.
Well, it was a cold start to the day, but it is warming up quickly out there. Meteorologist Scott Harbaugh is tracking even higher temperatures on the way.
You can see the sunshine in Mike's shot. Plenty of sunshine on tower cam right now. This is looking from fine view into the city of Pittsburgh. 50 degrees right now. No wind, so no added chill. And you step outside, feels pretty good right now. 50 in Washington, 48 currently in Greensburg. Butler, 49. Couple high, thin clouds moving in. That's about the extent of it. Most of the afternoon, it's going to be sunshine, and we'll creep into the low 60s late this afternoon. It's just a couple clouds working their way in. Warmer temperatures will also mean some spring thunderstorms later this week. I'm updating Storm Tracker, and I'll have it for you in a couple minutes, showing you when you'll need the umbrella in your neighborhood.
All right, thanks, Scott. Another 5,000 Pittsburgh public school students are back in the classroom today. We're working to find out if all the kids made it to school, considering the district is facing a major bus driver shortage. The district is short about 200 drivers. A1 Transit says it's hiring more.
Patience. Patience with us, because we're doing the best we can with the amount of drivers that we have. I mean, my office staff's on the road, so it's, you know, whoever we have, they're on the road.
Parents who can drive their kids and their friends to school are a huge help. Also, the district has previously provided students with Connect tickets to use the Port Authority buses to get to school. To help resolve the bus problem, they're talking about using public transportation as another option to get students to school, even elementary school students. The district is also talking about altering start times for students, although nothing has been finalized just yet. Another big test comes next week when 10,000 more students are set to return to school. There is a school board meeting tonight, and we do expect board members to talk about the bus driver shortage. We'll bring you the very latest on WPXI tonight, and we'll put it on the WPXI's news app. A 17-year-old was shot and killed in the Hill District, and despite several witnesses being questioned by police, still no arrests have been made. Isaiah Freeman died after he was taken to the hospital Saturday night. Police say they were called to Bedford Avenue and saw Freeman being put into a car and then followed that car to the hospital. Pittsburgh police are asking for help finding this woman. They say Asha Brown hit a man with her car after a fight in Homewood. The 25-year-old is now charged with homicide. Police questioned witnesses and say they have surveillance video showing Brown hitting Vaughn Washington with a car on Kelly Street last Tuesday night. The two had been dating for about 2 weeks. Police say they found text messages showing Washington accused Brown of seeing other people. Police say a driver crashed in Penn Hills and took off before police could question him. When we pulled up to Frankstown Avenue this morning, Duquesne Light was replacing a utility pole that was sheared early this morning. Police say the driver also took out a fire hydrant. A witness told officers they saw the driver get into another car and speed away. And around midnight, another driver crashed into a utility pole in Oakmont. This was on Halton Road near 8th Street, and that crash knocked out power to more than 600 people. That driver was given a sobriety test and was taken into custody. The FBI is now warning workers to look out for bogus job postings. Our Alyssa Raymond spoke with the owner of a local staffing agency who says she's not surprised job hunters are now being targeted.
If you're looking for a job right now, listen to this warning from the FBI. They say cyber criminals are using fake job listings to target applicants, taking their money as well as their personal information. A local staffing agency says job openings aren't hard to find right now.
There are tons of jobs out there. At any given time, probably now, I have about 100 openings.
Pam Wagand owns Crown Employment Services. While she's seeing more employers looking for employees, she's not seeing an uptick in fake job scams locally. She says it's not surprising. Fake job scams have been around for a long time, but technology has made it even easier for criminals. According to the FBI's Internet Crime Complaint Center, about 16,000 people reported being victims of employment scams in 2020. Their combined losses totaled more than $59 million.
Make sure it's a legitimate company. I would say look up and make sure there is a website for the company, as well as there's a lot of new companies opening up. But I, you know, would tell you to do your due diligence regarding looking for a job. You know, it is a job to look for a job.
So what should job seekers keep an eye out for? The FBI is sharing some tips plus the red flags. I'm compiling that information for a story on Channel 11 News at 5. Reporting on the north side, Alyssa Raymond, Channel 11 News.
Restaurant workers are protesting right now at Live Casino Pittsburgh in Westmoreland County. Workers at Guy Fieri's American Kitchen are upset about alleged pay discrimination and harassment. Earlier this month, they sent a petition to management for improved working conditions. It now has 3,000 signatures. We are at that protest, and you can look for developing details tonight on Channel 11 News starting at 5. The United Steelworkers Union has until 5 o'clock this afternoon to agree to the latest contract offer. The union turned down Allegheny Technology's ultimatum last week, but the union accused ATI of intimidating members. ATI says it's focused on getting workers a new contract. The Supreme Court has agreed to hear a case on gun laws. The High Court announced this morning it will consider the scope of the Second Amendment in a case concerning a New York law that restricts a person from carrying concealed handguns in public. It's been more than a decade since the justices ruled on a case concerning the right to bear arms. An important milestone is approaching for the Biden administration, the end of the president's first 100 days in office. NBC's Tracy Potts takes a closer look at a new presidential poll on how Americans think Biden is doing.
As President Biden prepares to address Congress this week, a new NBC News poll gives him a 53% approval rating for his first 100 days ahead of Donald Trump, but behind Barack Obama at the same point. His highest rating, 69% for handling the pandemic.
I certainly think that he's taken the leadership role that I was hoping that he would.
More than half the country gives Biden a thumbs up on the economy, but he fares much lower on gun policies and immigration, with only a third approving of how he's handled the crisis at the border.
It's not going to be solved overnight. It's a complex issue. Listen, if this were easy, it would have been handled years ago.
Arizona's governor declared a state of emergency, deploying 250 National Guard troops. He wants more resources from the federal government.
If the administration isn't going to do anything, then Arizona will.
In his first joint address to Congress Wednesday, Biden is expected to push for immigration reform, police reform, and stricter gun laws. Tracy Potts, NBC News.
Add another COVID-19 variant to the list. What makes this strain different from the rest?
We just want them to go home to their families at night.
PennDOT says it needs cameras to protect its workers. How much it will cost you if the camera catches you speeding on I-79.
Warmer air will also mean some spring thunderstorms. I'm tracking when you hear some thunder coming up.
Another COVID-19 variant has popped up, this time on the campus of Texas A&M University. They found the strain named BV1 in a student on March 5th. It then took 5 weeks for the student to test negative for COVID because it's the first of its kind. Researchers don't know why BV1 lasted so long in this student.
Is it typical for coronavirus in general? No. For most people of the age of the student, we would expect them to have virus inside them for a week to 10 days, 2 weeks at the tops.
According to the CDC, there are officially 5 variants of coronavirus in the U.S. that does not include BV1 at this point. For the first time in nearly 6 months, the Allegheny County Courthouse will hold a jury trial. Jury trials will start back up today in a modified fashion. Days of jury selection happening in the courthouse are a thing of the past for now. Selection will happen at the David O. Lawrence Convention Center, and there will only be one jury trial at a time at the courthouse. A touching tribute for a young woman whose life was taken too soon. Family, friends, and former teammates and coaches gathered to celebrate Caitlin Eckleberry over the weekend. She's from Uniontown, Ohio, and played softball there. Caitlin graduated from Gannon University and had just started working at Chatham University here in Pittsburgh as an assistant softball coach. Caitlin was killed last year after her car was hit head-on on Route 8 in Hampton Township. Police say the woman who was driving the other car was driving drunk. New efforts are underway to protect road crews in work zones. 2 years ago, there were more than 1,300 work zone crashes in Pennsylvania. Channel 11's Kara Sepaito shows us how new cameras are being used to catch speeders on Interstate 79.
PennDOT officials tell me they've already issued more than 20,000 citations just on this stretch of 79 alone, all thanks to this new technology that can catch multiple speeders at once. On Interstate 79 in Washington County, there's major construction. As many as 100 workers on the side of the road some days. PennDOT says in an effort to slow down drivers, they've put in one of their newest forms of technology. Automated work zone enforcement. It's a portable system actually inside of this vehicle. If you're going more than 11 miles over the work zone speed limit, it will snap your car's photo and the car speeding next to you as well.
It uses two different kinds of radar technology to compute the speed of the vehicle, and it takes a picture of the front and the back of the vehicle, and it can do multiple vehicles at the same time.
I drive through there every day.
Julia Bavaro drives this stretch of I-79 in her work vehicle. She was surprised to hear from her boss that she received a citation in the mail. She has been warning people on social media to slow down.
I've been only doing like 48 at most through there in the right lane. I see people flying by me doing 60, 65, and it's insane.
There's one goal, and the goal is to improve safety and within our work zones. Slow people down and improve safety.
We asked PennDOT how many citations they've sent. They say 220,000 across the state over the last year and more than 20,000 on this stretch of I-79 where the Turnpike is building the Southern Beltway. Drivers speeding will get a warning in the mail. Second offense is $75. Third is a $150 fine. No points given. PennDOT says this kind of enforcement is saving lives.
Please try to remember to slow down in work zones. It's people's family members working out there, men and women every single day, that we just want them to go home, their families at night.
Kara Sepaita, Channel 11 News.
New at noon, the city of Pittsburgh is launching an abandoned vehicle blitz tomorrow, focusing first on Allentown and Beltsuver and later spreading to other neighborhoods. You can report abandoned vehicles by calling the city's 311 response center. Police will repeat the blitz throughout the city over the next few weeks. A dangerous driver caused a wild scene in Albania. Take a look at this. You can see him driving his car backwards in circles in the heart of the capital. And apparently hanging out of the car. This is in the city's main square. As the car was threatening people in the square, a man jumped feet first through the driver's window to end the threat. Before this scene, the driver had already crashed into three cars in other parts of the city. A pink supermoon lit up the Australian sky today. Crowds flocked to Bondi Beach to observe the first supermoon of 2021. A supermoon is a name given to a full moon that occurs when the moon is closest to the Earth. According to NASA, this year's supermoon has been called a pink supermoon as it appears in April and named after an American plant that blooms in the spring.
Severe weather Team 11 forecast.
That would be the pink moss plant. That's why it's been given this name. And it's one of our many full moons during the course of the year. April, the pink moon. Peak time tonight, 11:33 is when it's technically full. And the viewing around here should be pretty good tonight. It's going to appear 15% brighter, 7% bigger than a normal full moon. And with just a couple of clouds tonight, you should get a pretty good view. Weather in a word during the daylight hours. Sunny, plenty of sunshine this afternoon. So if you're heading outside this afternoon with the kids, going to be outside after school, make sure they have the sunscreen. UV forecast today, 7. That means burn time in as little as 25 minutes. If you have particularly sensitive skin, could have a little bit earlier on the burn time. Sunglasses, hat, always a good idea as we head through April, May, and into the summer months. 64 for the high temperature in Pittsburgh today. Butler, 61. Washington, 63 degrees. Finally getting back to more seasonal levels, and then tomorrow, going to blow the doors off. The temperatures tomorrow well above normal as we approach 80 degrees. Overnight tonight, comfortably cool for this time of the year, 46 with it. Full moon tonight. Get away from the city lights to enjoy it the most tonight. Tomorrow, partly sunny and 80. So no heavy coat tomorrow. As you head out the door, you might want a light jacket very early. Just shirt sleeves during the afternoon. Not humid during the day tomorrow either, but humidity will be on the way back tomorrow night and Wednesday. And with that, the chance of thunderstorms coming back into the forecast. Here's Storm Tracker Wednesday. Might be a sprinkle or two in the morning, but most of the daylight hours will be dry. 6 o'clock in the evening. Look at the red. Up north of the I-80 corridor. Could be some pretty good thunderstorms working their way into the area. 6, 7, 8 o'clock on Wednesday night. That round heads out. Then here comes another round in by 11 o'clock at night. Could be a few rounds of thunderstorms Wednesday evening into the overnight hours. Now, by the time we hit the air Thursday morning on Channel 11 Morning News, on just a couple of scattered showers around the area. But right now, Thursday, looking like a fairly soggy day across the area. At the moment, I'm not expecting any widespread severe weather. Storm Prediction Center Wednesday has the entire area under the risk for thunderstorms. I do believe, though, that when they make an update to Wednesday, which will be first thing tomorrow morning, some of our area, especially to the northwest of Pittsburgh, might get put in the marginal risk for severe thunderstorms just because the dynamics in this area look better for a thunderstorm that could produce 55, 60 mile per hour winds late Wednesday and Wednesday night. Regardless of whether you get a strong thunderstorm or not, rainfall looks appreciable as we go through the weekend. We're finally going to dry it out again, but getting to the weekend, it's going to be a little soggy. Late day storms Wednesday, showers off and on all day Thursday, and then there's a downtick in temperatures again as we head toward the weekend. Friday, a couple showers in 61 degrees. Coming up next half hour, putting together a map to show you exactly how much rain you can expect the second half of the week.
James!
James!
A man given away at birth was reunited with his biological father. How they found each other after 57 years apart. But first, Kennywood and Sandcastle are on a hiring spree, the incentive they're offering to bring in new workers. In less than 2 weeks, Kennywood will open for the season. The park is making a push to hire more workers so they can keep it open longer this year. Kennywood also, along with Sandcastle and Idlewild, are trying to bring in 900 new team members. Channel 11's Shelley Bortz explains how the park is trying to attract the best workers.
We want to get back to that schedule that's, you know, open more days, open more hours.
It's a sign that life as we know it is finally coming back, from Hollywood movie openings to Major League Baseball games. And it makes sense that we would see this slow progression as vaccinations increase.
We are, you know, really encouraged and seeing a lot of good indicators for this season, better than maybe we'd initially projected. And so in order to expand our schedules back to closer what they would have been prior to the pandemic, we want to bring on a lot more team members than we were initially planning to.
Paradise tells me the parks would like to hire an additional 900 employees. In order to attract those potential team members, the parks are willing to pay more. Adults over the age of 18 will get $4 to $5 more an hour.
We're going to start at $13 an hour, not just for Kennywood, but Sandcastle and Idlewild as well. To make sure not just we're getting, you know, a lot of candidates, but really good candidates, the best the market has to offer.
The parks are looking for all positions, including lifeguards, ride operators, and food and beverage. To sweeten the pot even more, Paradise says these new hires will get a variety of perks and bonuses.
We're going to give them a basic season pass for themselves and up to three additionals for members of their immediate families.
The one thing that won't change this year is the park's commitment to health and safety. All three parks will continue to follow the recommendations of the CDC and the health department.
We are going to still require the facial covering, still asking people to sanitize as they get on and off each ride, increasing the cleaning, managing capacity throughout the park. Safety is going to be our topmost priority. It always is here.
Shelley Bortz, Channel 11 News.
Summer warmth is going to mean some spring thunderstorms. I'm tracking when you'll see the rain arrive in your neighborhood.
We feel vaccine is the game changer.
Colleges across the country are mandating students get vaccinated, but is that legal? The history they have on their side. Well, a cold start to the day, but pretty mild this afternoon. And meteorologist Scott Harbaugh is tracking a big warm-up in Severe Weather Center 11.
Yeah, definitely sunglasses this afternoon as well, Gordon. You can see looking into downtown Pittsburgh from Fine View with Tower Cam. It's a live look right now. Lots of sunshine, hardly a cloud around. Temperatures near that 50-degree mark in most areas. So depending on your comfort level, maybe still a light jacket for the next couple of hours. But the temperatures will continue to climb this afternoon. A great afternoon for the kids at the playground. Just don't forget the sunscreen. 62 degrees at 4 p.m., 63 at 6 o'clock this evening. Now, temperatures are really going to warm up this week, but I am tracking some thunderstorms and some fairly heavy rainfall. Putting a map together right now to show you how much rain you can expect Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. I'll have that for you coming up in about 15 minutes.
All right, thanks, Scott. The race to vaccinate America is getting a big boost. The Johnson & Johnson single-shot vaccine is available again after being put on hold for 10 days. The CDC and FDA now recommend the shots. The question is, will people trust the vaccine? Sam Brock has the developing details.
With Johnson & Johnson fully re-entering the vaccine marketplace, the real question right now is how many Americans are going to feel comfortable actually taking the doses. I'm at a federally supported site here in Miami as you see people filing away after they've been vaccinated behind me. I asked hundreds of folks how comfortable they are. The vast majority of them on Sunday told me they have some reservations about J&J, and the numbers here really reflected that. They did about 3,000 shots on Sunday, 195 were J&J. Now, this is coming at a critical juncture for the country as the amount of people getting doses is dipping. It's now 2.8 million Americans a day. That's the lowest that rate has been since the end of March. At the same time, many states right now are scaling back on the amount of federal doses that they're receiving. That's true in places like Arkansas, Louisiana, Iowa. Public health officials there telling me that one of the reasons behind it certainly is people are choosing not to get vaccinated. There is an educational campaign going on right now to try to inform those who either have reservations or certainly are just hesitant about the idea of getting a vaccine in general. Other key points to hit upon this morning, Dr. Anthony Fauci saying that the CDC may be adjusting its guidelines on masking, certainly for people who are vaccinated, perhaps for those who are not vaccinated, as many health experts right now aren't sure it's necessary in small groups outside. We should be learning more about that in the coming days. In Miami, Sam Brock, NBC News.
Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer is urging restaurant owners to apply for federal aid as part of the Save Our Restaurants Act. $28 billion will let restaurant owners apply for grants to cover COVID-related losses from this year and last. The maximum grant for each restaurant is $5 million, and it's first come, first serve for those who apply.
So hopefully, at some point in June, money will be in our restaurateurs' hands so they can stay alive and stay open until, God willing, COVID is over, the streets are full, and the restaurants are full once again.
This relief program is part of the total $1.9 trillion COVID relief package signed into law last month. A growing list of colleges are making the vaccine mandatory before students return to campus in the fall.
We feel vaccine is the game changer for us to bring back as many people as we can. They deserve to have the experience that they have been looking forward to, and we think that this is a small price to pay to do it.
Students at nearly 75 colleges must have a proof of a shot before the fall semester. That includes Rutgers, Duke, and Notre Dame. Vaccine mandates in education go back a long time. Traditionally, they've been upheld by courts because they increase safety in areas vulnerable to outbreaks. But the first challenge could come from Florida. One day after Nova Southeastern University announced it would require vaccinations, the governor there issued an executive order banning businesses from asking to see proof of a COVID-19 vaccine. Some schools are avoiding mandates like Ohio State that encourages everyone to get a vaccine, but other universities like Pitt are still debating policy for the fall. National College Decision Day is almost here, a deadline the class of 2021 has been preparing for since their junior year. If your senior hasn't committed to a school yet, NBC's Dan Jetterman has some tips that may help make the decision easier.
The pressure is on for high school seniors across the country. The deadline to make final college and university decisions is May 1st. So how does a student choose? Experts say make a list of what is important to you with everything from location, majors, and even divisional sports.
There's so much hype and so much in U.S. news and so much around the rankings, around where you have to go, but really looking at the fit and where you belong and what's important to you.
Finances also play a big factor. Consider where you want to be in 5 years and if the cost of education will garner you an appropriate salary after graduation. and use your financial aid package to negotiate with other schools.
Maybe it'll help by a few thousand, but a few thousand is better than no thousand.
What if you are waitlisted?
It's really a mistake that students make to think that it's something that they did to cause them to be on the waitlist. And it's really all about what's happening on the college side of things.
Cancellations of SAT and ACTs during the pandemic forced colleges to adopt test optional policies when applying to schools.
Universities have seen 20, 30, 40, 50, 60% increases in their applications. As a result, colleges have no choice but to put all of these very qualified students on a wait list.
If you don't get into your dream school, experts say consider a community college and transferring in your sophomore or junior year. Dan Shenneman, NBC News.
And more details, the new Arts Bridge survey asked if college in a COVID era is worth it. 62% of high school seniors and their parents worry the experience won't be the same, while 82% of college freshmen say they'd do it again.
James!
A man given away at birth, reunited with his biological father, how they found each other after 57 years apart. Into the basement. People are stepping up to help after a fire destroyed thousands of dollars in equipment at a Little League shed in Latrobe. After our story aired, Pirates Charities and Dick's Sporting Goods announced they are replacing the shed and equipment, and businesses in the area also donated money. Someone set that fire on purpose last weekend. The only thing not covered by insurance was the deductible, and cash donations will cover that. The team should be able to start their season in 5 weeks. The high school football field in Leechburg is getting a facelift. The district started talking about improvements more than a year ago, but Borough Council just gave the go-ahead last week. According to our partners at the Trib, upgrades include synthetic turf and a track. They also plan to add drainage pipes to cut down on stormwater runoff.
Yeah, there they are.
There they
top
are.
Of the stairs.
Is that them?
That's yep, them, that's right there at the top of the stairs with the balloons. Hey, Jim!
James!
excitement in their voice. A father and son back together after being apart for 57 years. The father had been looking for his son ever since the boy's mother gave him up for adoption. That was back in 1963. So he took a DNA test, and it turns out his son had been looking for him as well, and they matched in the online database.
Number one dad. Found him.
The son and his family will spend a week in Myrtle Beach getting to know their father. And get this, before the dad moved to South Carolina, the two had lived just 30 minutes away from each other.
80s tomorrow, thunderstorms Wednesday. I'm tracking the arrival time in your neighborhood.
Protecting your credit line is an uphill battle, but it can be done. Our consumer advisor shows us the one simple step to take to make a big difference. Sometimes it seems nearly impossible to protect your privacy and information these days, but our consumer advisor Clark Howard has one simple way you can protect your credit.
Our personal information is out there everywhere. So sometimes you just give up because, well, somebody can cause so much mischief in your life. Don't do that. Because although there are multiple ways people can cause trouble in your life, there's one in particular that you can focus on and make a big difference. And that is where you shut down someone's ability to apply for credit as if they're you, even if they have your social security number and other key information. If you follow a simple, easy, quick process known as credit freeze, you will shut them down cold from getting new credit as if they're you. And it won't affect the credit you already have. Simple to do. Go to clark.com/creditfreeze, and you'll be able to put it in place with the major credit bureaus in just minutes. And don't worry, when you need to legitimately apply for credit for yourself, it takes just a minute to thaw your credit so you can do your new application. I'm Clark Howard.
TripAdvisor says 67% of Americans plan to travel this summer, with most staying in the U.S. That's resulted in a boom for vacation rental searches. The most popular destinations include typical sun and fun beach spots for fresh air and space for social distancing. TripAdvisor says Florida is on the top of the wish list. The CDC has released guidance for ways to keep kids safe at summer camp. The agency recommends most group activities be held outdoors. They say kids can sit within 3 feet of one another if they wear a mask. The CDC also recommends children don't share items, and each camper should have their own cubby to store personal items. The CDC also urges any camp worker over the age of 16 to get a vaccine as soon as possible.
Your severe weather Team 11 forecast.
Well, it's going to be feeling like summer around here beginning tomorrow, but this morning, chilly air still in place. I want to put a couple maps together to show you the big swing in temperatures we're going to see between this morning in tomorrow afternoon. Here are all the areas this morning at 7 a.m. that were 40 degrees or colder, and this went all the way in to the North Georgia mountains. The entire state of Pennsylvania was colder than 40 degrees. Fast forward to tomorrow afternoon. Who's going to be 70 or warmer tomorrow? How about most of Pennsylvania, all of Ohio, all of Indiana, as a warm surge of air pushes up from the south? And this is the beginning of a couple days of unseasonably warm temperatures across our region. Normally, we'd still be talking jackets in the afternoon with temperatures in the low 60s. Tomorrow and Wednesday, we should make 80 degrees. Not quite there yet. 50 degrees currently in Pittsburgh, 49 in Butler, and 48 in Greensburg. So still light jacket weather today and sunglasses as well. Notice the visible satellite, most of the area fairly clear. Got some clouds up in Venango, Clarion, and Forest County, but they're not producing any sort of rain whatsoever. So suncast for today, about 13 hours worth of sunshine today. About 11 and a half during the day tomorrow. We'll see a couple clouds tomorrow, but not terrible. Then Wednesday, more cloud cover than sunshine. Thursday is not going to be a very pretty day and a little wet as well. So if you want to get the car washed, today one of the two best days to do it. You could do it tomorrow as well, but a little warm tomorrow. Maybe the water can cool you off. Today, 64 degrees at 5 o'clock, 62 at 8 o'clock. Today, that sun not setting now till 8:12 in the evening. Overnight tonight, few clouds, 46. Pink supermoon tonight, peaks at 11:53, 11:33. That's when it's technically full. Good views tonight with just a couple clouds around. During the day tomorrow, going to push it all the way up to 80 degrees. Partly sunny, breezy, and very warm tomorrow. Those wind gusts early tomorrow afternoon, up near 25, 26 miles per hour. But it's going to be a warm southwest wind bringing in that air that's going to be with us not only tomorrow, but into Wednesday as well. And with it, some humidity and the chance of some showers and thunderstorms. Here's Storm Tracker Wednesday morning. Fairly quiet in the morning. Could pick up a couple of sprinkles, but notice later in the day, here comes some thunderstorms starting to pop, and there could be some strong thunderstorms too, especially northwest of Pittsburgh. Another wave comes through about midnight then, so we head into Thursday morning off and on showers. It's not going to rain all day Thursday, but it's going to rain a good chunk of the day Thursday. And if you tally up the rain Wednesday, Thursday into Friday, most areas are going to see about an inch or two of rain. Head up along the I-80 corridor, could be some pockets of 2 to 3 inches of rain, so good solid soaking. No flash flood concerns as of right now, but stay with Severe Weather Team 11. We'll keep you posted as we go through the week. 5-day forecast with your weekend always in view. We only hit the 80 degree mark twice this week. Then Thursday, 71 with that off and on rain throughout the day. Friday, couple showers, a little cooler, 61 degrees, and the weekend looks good. Seasonal, lots of sunshine this weekend, high temperatures in the 60s.
A 250-year-old bottle of whiskey is set to be auctioned off in June. It is the oldest known whiskey in existence. Scientists say it was likely bottled between 1763 and 1803. And it was likely a gift, and it's been safeguarded for generations. It could go for as much as $40,000. If you're looking for a new car, you may have trouble finding one. Dealerships are running low on inventory, and the average cost for a new vehicle is up almost $2,000 compared to last year. That's because the pandemic caused a worldwide shortage in computer chips. Car manufacturers have been forced to pause production for weeks. On the flip side, though, if you're looking to sell, Kelley Blue Book says they've seen a 13% increase in used car prices.
Wouldn't it be wonderful if you had five key people with you every moment of the day? You would never be alone. You would never worry. You would never be afraid. Well, that might not be possible, but I have the next best thing. This is a brand new concept called Invisiware. This is a beautiful necklace. You literally just push the button and it alerts five people that you're in trouble and where you are by a GPS location. So think about it. You're walking to your car in a parking lot, you're by yourself, something's not right. You use your rideshare app, you're in the car, something's not right. You're going to, you're leaving somewhere, you're walking down the street, you're by yourself at night, something's not right. Maybe it's you, maybe it's your daughter, maybe it's your niece, maybe it's your mom, maybe it's your sister, maybe it's your best friend. Every woman has felt that. This is a brand new concept that I know you're gonna love. Please meet the young lady who actually developed it. This is Raja.
It looks like a beautiful piece of jewelry, and people never believe this, but it's actually got a safety device hidden on the inside. There's a button. If you press it two times, it immediately sends a text message to five people that you pre-select in the free app. And there's a feature to allow it to optionally contact 911 as well. When you double press it during an emergency, it sends your loved ones a link to your live location so that they can send help. Thank you so much to Local Steals and Deals for having me and for the audience listening. I'm so thrilled to be able to help keep you safe and to keep your loved ones safe.
Thank you so much, Raja. I think this is one of the most amazing designs. By the way, this keeps you safe with no monthly monitoring fee, which I think is very important. It comes in the gold tone or silver tone, beautifully gift boxed and ready to go. And right now on localsteals.com, it is 28% off. So start making a list of everyone you love and you want to get one for.
Three peregrine falcons hatched yesterday in the nest on top of the Cathedral of Learning. This is a live look from the National Aviary Camera on Pitt's campus in Oakland. And you can see one of the parents keeping the new additions warm. A fourth egg has yet to hatch. The Cathedral of Learning has been home to a pair of peregrines since 2001. Cleaning up Pittsburgh one corner at a time. That's the goal of a new campaign. Yesterday was Pick a Corner Day. And the goal is for people to pick trash up where they see it and then put it out for trash pickup. The group was inspired by what they saw driving around town.
He drives to work every day on this road, and it was always messy. So we decided to give something back to society, and we came out and picked it up, and it made us both feel really good. And we just thought, why doesn't everybody do this one day?
And she thinks if everyone picks a corner or a street to clean up, Pittsburgh will look a lot more beautiful. It would be great to see. That's all for Channel 11 News at Noon. Thanks for joining us. Our next newscast is tonight at 5. Have a great day.